Tales from the toilet.
Ah, yes. Welcome back to the crypt. I have my favorite skull here. I love that new intro, by the way. I hope you like it too. It really speaks to my character. And, yes. New season, new intro, I decided. I'm just hoping that nobody breaks into my home after seeing me walk in there. Because they might have seen that it was unlocked and walked in. Speaking of home invasion stories, I have one here today, a delectable story that I'm sure you'll just love to hear. It was called I Survived a Home Invasion by somebody. I don't know who, and I do not care. But, alas, all music and anything else that might be copyright claimed later on is under fair use, and I do not own any of that music. So, with that, let's
Someone get was into planning to kill me or my family. I never thought it would happen in my lifetime, as I have no enemies. I'm almost 20 years old. I live with my wife, who is a little older than me, my two boys, who are still in diapers, my mother and father-in-law, and my brother-in-law. Thursday night. My wife had left to go to work. Nobody was home, and my brother-in-law was with his cousin, and my wife's parents were off seeing a movie. My wife had left at 6 p.m.-ish, and she would usually be home before 7:30 p.m. There were no cars parked in the garage, as if nobody was home, and almost all of the lights in the house were off, except the kitchen light, which was almost always on, and the light at the end of the hallway towards the garage. I was left home alone to watch the boys. One is 2, and the other is almost 1. My oldest had started laying on my youngest rocker and was kicking my youngest away from him when he kicked him in the face, after I told him not to kick his brother, which knocked him down and he let out a nasty scream. I then get furious at my oldest and set him on the couch and told him not to move a muscle, as he had to sit in time out. He then began to get up and crawl across the couch. I then get up and raise my voice in a firm tone and grab him by the arms and sit him back down. As I was raising my voice, I hear the garage door leading into our house close. I then go and sit on the other couch with my one-year-old waiting for my wife to walk into the living room. I had taken notice of the time because I was going to sit my oldest in timeout for 10 minutes. It was 7:40 p.m., so I was sure she was going to be walking in. After about 30 seconds, I realized no one was walking in the house. I then get up and yell for my wife to come out, figured she was hiding to see how I disciplined the boys while she was gone, and I didn't get a reply. Let me explain the house layout for later in the horror story. We live in an upgraded modular home. It is a 5-bedroom house. You walk in the front door, and just to the left is the dining room, which leads to the living room / kitchen. As you walk in, the kitchen is to the left and the living room to the right. Between them, it's one big room, is a door that leads to a room at the end of our house. When you walk into our room, my youngest crib is to the left, and behind his crib is a dresser with a little room in between. In front of the door, across my room, is my oldest son's crib, and in between them, to the left, is our bed, and 2 windows on each side of our bed. If you were to walk out of our room, you would walk through the kitchen / living room, then into the dining room to the front door. Across the front door is a bathroom, and to the left and right are my in-laws' rooms. Past their rooms, down the hallway, turning right when you walk in the front of the house, there is a guest room in the middle of the hallway to the right. Keep walking down the hallway, and at the other end of the house, to the right, there is a room which my brother-in-law turned into his gaming room. and across from it is the basement door. Between his gaming room and the basement door is the garage door, which leads to the garage. Step out in the garage, and in line with the door leading in across the garage is a big window to the right. There's a door that leads to the front of the house, and we have a two-car garage, which is left of the door leading to the front of the house. I am 100% mentally healthy and physically fine. I know I didn't hear anything that wasn't there. I then scream for my wife to come out, and no reply. I own quite a few guns and shoot regularly, and have never had any formal training, though. I trade and gunsmith as a hobby, and I know more than most when regarding firearms. I then proceed to take my two boys and set them in their cribs in our room. I then grab my Walther PPQ 9mm and a flashlight and scream once more that if no one comes out, they will be shot on sight. I then proceed to clear the house to find that my wife actually never came home. Once my wife got home at around 8 p.m. and I explain what happens, she tells me I'm paranoid. She claims it is a demon as she thinks she hears things in the house and claims it's spirits and demons. My wife has bad anxiety and depression, and when she gets really worked up and she hears things that she knows are not there, she proceeds to tell me that I need to calm down because no one came into our house. Sometimes my wife's cousin Stephen, who lives two houses down from us, is roughly the same age as us, comes over to hang out with my brother-in-law. I forgot to mention, to the north, south, and west side of our house are fields, and at night you cannot see the fields. We live in BFE. To the east side of our house is where Stephen lives, about 200 yards away and a little behind us. We only have neighbors to our east, and there are about 7 houses, all of which are my wife's family. Across all of their houses, including ours, is a massive field across the street. I texted Stephen. He was over earlier looking at my new 44 Magnum I just got, and I asked him if he came back over and heard me yelling at my oldest and then left. He said he didn't come back. He would have came through the front door if he had, like always. Not through the garage, and I knew this. And I then proceeded to check the garage doors to see if they were locked. And surprise, surprise, the door in the garage that leads to the front of the house is unlocked. I then locked it and stayed up all night ready for someone to strike, though it never came. Saturday night. Saturday goes by as every other Saturday does. Wife goes to work throughout the day, and usually we just chill at home with the boys and in-laws. I stayed up Friday night until about 3:45 reading No Sleep Stories. Ever since I started reading them and what had taken place Thursday, my wife said I had started acting much more paranoid and that I needed to get some sleep. I agreed and let my guard down a little and went to bed early around 9:30 p.m. I was not prepared for what was about to happen. My wife wakes me up a little before 12 a.m. and says she's gotten the boys to sleep. We started talking about her coworkers and went and laid down in bed. My in-laws were all gone as my wife's brother was staying at Stephen's house, and my mother and in-laws were at his mom's house doing whatever the hell they were doing. I was in the bed checking my Facebook, and my wife was in the bathroom getting ready for bed. She had already went and turned the lights off in the house and locked the front door, leaving the garage door leading into the house unlocked so her parents could get in as always. I then heard a vehicle outside and went to look out the window beside my bed and noticed a blacked out SUV was driving down the road with their headlights off. Going into semi-panic mode, I then go get my wife to confirm what I was seeing. I told her to keep the lights out, and then I go out of our room to the window beside our front door, though not before grabbing my PPQ 9mm from under my mattress. Jesus Christ, this guy's fucking grammar is atrocious. It was a blacked out Yukon SUV with tinted windows, and they slowed way down once they passed our house. And about 200 yards away, they stopped barely in my eyesight, and my heart sank. I knew this was not going to be good. As this is happening, my wife is repeatedly asking me who it is. I tell her it was a blacked-out Yukon that they had stopped just past our house. I started to get a horrible feeling in my stomach. I told her to go back in the room, now. I frantically chambered a 9mm round in my PPQ and handed it to her, almost dropping it. She turned around and jogged back into our room, and I followed right behind her. I then went to my closet, which is to the right as you go in our room, and opened my gun safe and grabbed my Mossberg 9200 semi-auto 12 gauge that I hacked off to 18 inches, that I always keep loaded with 4 rounds of 3mm buck, and in one of the chambers for this exact moment. I go back to the window by the front door to seat all 3 men in black with black ski masks and black hats jogging at our house in the field on the west side of our house, making their way towards the garage. By then, I really went into panic mode because I saw one of them had a long gun, which turned out to be a pump 12 gauge. I then turned around and told my wife to get the boys and get into the bathroom and call the cops. And she started having a panic attack. What the fuck, dude? I followed her into our room and grabbed my oldest and put him in the tub in our bathroom, which is in our room, and to the far right corner, while my wife grabbed my youngest, I decided to take a stand, waiting just behind our bedroom door. I could see down the hallway through a crack between the door and wall. I prayed it was just going to be a sick prank, but I knew it was going to be much worse. I then heard the garage door open and was about to shit my pants. The 3 men came in, but I knew quietly. I didn't know how they got in at the time, but now know they had broken a large window in the garage that's directly across from the door leading into the house. I was watching them eagerly as I heard my boys crying in the bathroom with my wife, who I could hear crying as well, and hoping she had the police on the phone. I saw them looking into the game room and then the guest room, while the one with the shotgun was taking lead and another was shining a flashlight and flipped the hallway light on. I quickly and quietly checked to make sure I was loaded up and the action on the shotgun was closed and safety off. I know my wife heard them in the house too, because she started to cry even louder. The one with the shotgun had slowly made his way to the door with the other two behind him, and I knew they could hear the crying coming from the bathroom. The moment he opened the door is when it became so real. They were going to try and kill us, kill my wife and kids. I didn't even think about locking my bedroom door, though. I don't think it would have made much a difference. I had backed up to the left side of our room and was ducking behind my son's crib, in between his crib and my wife's dresser. While they searched my wife's brother and parents' room, the door flew open and my wife heard this and called my name with a blood-curdling scream. I saw him walk in, the shotgun leveled, and as soon as I saw his face, he had turned to check the room and seen me pop out, swinging my shotgun level to his head. He had clearly not expecting it and tried backing up, letting out a shit, and letting the first shot ring through the house and the ceiling. I shot him right in the fucking face, pulling the trigger with adrenaline and fear, pumping 3 rounds of 3 millimeter buck in him as fast as I could. 3mm Magnum 12 gauge kicks like hell. Only the first 2 shots hit him, and the third missed, going into my door. It nearly blew his head completely off and splattering blood and brains all over my door walls. And wall was leaking all over the floor. He dropped dead instantly, and his shotgun fell to the floor. I then hear my wife scream like I've never heard her screaming, with my hearing almost completely busted. I then heard metal hitting the floor, and now know one of the other two had a large knife as well. The other two with some of their buddies' blood on them as they hauled ass towards the other end of the house. One went to the locked front door and the other started to the garage door. I shot at the one running towards the garage door first, and one of them shot, and some of the shot hit him in the lower back as I saw it hit his sweatshirt. And just as the one by the door was getting it open, I shot him directly in the back. It made a horrible noise and fell right out the front door. I continued trying to pull the trigger again and realized I was empty. With both wounded, I then proceeded to head back into my closet to my gun safe, throwing my shotgun on the couch and almost slipping on blood and brains while screaming at my wife that I'm still alive because she wouldn't stop screaming for it to stop. I grabbed my SKS, which had a 30 round mag loaded up in it, and charged it into battery and made my way outside as quick as possible. The man I shot in the back at the front door was dead, 5 feet from our front door, and the other was 3/4 of the way back to the blacked out Yukon that had still now had its taillights on. Fuck me, his grammar. I ran like hell to the edge of the field with so much adrenaline and fear and gunned down the last man standing, breathing super heavy and barely holding my rifle still. I started spraying bullets and had hit him 4 times in the chest. Jesus Christ, man. Once in the ass, which had taken him down, and he eventually died in the field. The next 10 to 15 rounds went into the Yukon that was now peeling its tires, and I heard a few rounds hit it. The police came flying up a few minutes later, and a lot showed up. Dealing with them was also kind of been a nightmare on its own. My wife and son are permanently damaged from this whole ordeal, and so is my hearing. We're staying in a hotel now, and I am now just getting enough time to write this all out. I thought I was ready for a scenario like this. I thought about it often. I thought I would be cool, calm, and collected, but I was scared fucking shitless, and we're lucky to be alive. Keep your guns locked and loaded, and always have a plan for unexpected visitors in the night, as this has been a huge fucking nightmare. Edit. I could possibly be going to prison for murder because I chased them down.
I'm not going to lie, that was actually quite good. But I have a couple gripes with it. You see, the amount of guns that this man has is kind of ridiculous. It sounds like he has a ton, which is kind of annoying, because the story makes him a bit overpowered, which I do not like. Anyway, that's just a minor gripe. Oh, I had guns, they can save me. You know, yes, they can save you, but whatever. Another thing that I do not like about this story is the fact that he's a 20-year-old man who's married, has 2 children, and lives with 3 other people. 3 other people. That's 4 things that would make it strange as to why he has such poor grammar. And he has like a disclaimer at the beginning that says, I'm not a writer. Well, you should still have proper grammar. Like, that's no excuse. That's ridiculous. Anyway, this does sound like a real story. So, I mean, yeah, it's possible. Imagine you're sitting there in your home at night with your loved ones. And then people come in through your garage. And they have guns. And there's 3 of them, and there's only 2 of you. And 2 useless other kids. But yeah, that would be quite terrifying. So overall, I'd give this story about a 5 out of 10. What would you rate it? And what would you change about the story to make it better? Tell me in the comment section below. If you liked, then subscribe. If you liked it and enjoyed, then like and subscribe. And I will see all of you in the next video. Goodbye. Noir here, aka the Crypt Keeper, aka your mom's lover. I just wanted to say thank you for helping us reach 35 subscribers. That is awesome. And hopefully we'll be getting more in the future. So I just wanted to say thank you. Yeah. I will be having a collaboration with Chase Ross very soon, like probably my next video. I will be having a collaboration with him, so keep your eyes out for that. Stay tuned. But yeah, that's pretty much it. See you guys later. Bye.